The tween behavior is one of the new behaviors added in the latest version of Construct 3, and it gives us the ability to use tweens on sprites and their properties. That means we have even more options when it comes to animating sprites in our games. Tweening is the process of taking the first and last positions of an object and automatically generating the frames between the two positions. This can be applied to the position of an object, or its size, rotation, or any other value that you want to use a tween on. Tweens are useful for creating animations and movements that look more interesting than they would if we were just scaling their size up by a fixed rate, or moving them across the screen at a steady speed. We'll talk about how we can use easing to adjust the rate the tweened value changes over time, giving a more natural feel to the animations in your games. Let's take a look at an example. I've got a couple sprite objects set up with the tween behavior already applied to them. I'll drag out an instance of the circle sprite and place it on the left side of the screen. Let's tween the circle across the canvas when we click it. Switch to the event sheet and add a new event using the touch object. And choose on tap object. Then select the circle sprite. Add an action using the circle sprite. And scroll down to the tween category. There are three tween types available to us: the one property tween, the two property tween, and the value tween. One property affects only a single value, while two properties affects two values. The value tween lets you apply a tween between two values, and you can assign the corresponding result to any other property in the event sheet. Let's take a look at a one property tween first. Select tween, one property, and click next. We've got some parameters we can change to set up how the tween behaves. First, we've got tag, which lets you add a tag so that you can refer to this specific tween in other places in the event sheet. We'll look at how to do that later, so let's leave it blank for now. Next, we've got property, which lets us choose the property we want the tween to affect. For a one property tween, we can apply it to the X position, the Y position, the width, height, angle, opacity, or color. For now, let's just tween the X position of the sprite. End value is the final value at the conclusion of the tween. So if we set this to 750, the circle's X position will be equal to 750 once the tween is complete. Time is how long it takes for the tween to complete, from its initial value until it reaches the end value. We'll set it to 2 seconds, so the animation's pretty short. Next, we have ease, which we'll look into more later. For now, just leave it set to linear. Last, destroy on complete, which is self-explanatory. The object will be destroyed when the tween is completed. Click Done, and press F5 to preview the layout. When we tap on the object, it starts moving to X750 over a period of 2 seconds. What if we wanted it to move back once we tap on it again after the tween is finished? We could do that with an if statement, checking the X position of the circle. Add a sub-event using the circle object, and choose compare X. The tween leaves the circle at X750, so let's check if the X coordinate is equal to 750. Let's check the circle's starting X position, which is 80. We can copy the sub-event we just created and paste it below. Then change it to check if the circle's X position is 80. Finally, drag the tween down to the X equals 80 event and control click to drag a copy to the X equals 750 event. Change the value we're tweening to on the X equals 750 event to 80. Now they should tween back and forth between these two positions. Press F5 to preview the layout, and the first tween still works as expected. And once the circle is on the other side of the layout, at X750, we can click it, and it tweens back to the other side, to X80. The position isn't the only parameter we can tween, though. Let's tween the size of the circle when we press the up or down arrow keys. Add a new event, using the keyboard object, and choose on key pressed. We'll use the up arrow. Add an action using the circle object. With the one property tween, we could either adjust the width or the height, but not both at the same time. For that, we need to use the two property tween. Scroll down to Tween, Two Properties, select it, and click Next. Everything here is the same as it was in the single property tween, except we have access to a second parameter, end Y, and the properties we have to choose from are limited to position and size. We'll be setting the size. Let's scale the circle up to 150 by 150 pixels. Over a period of 1 second. Copy and paste the event. And change it to be triggered by the down arrow. Then edit the action so that we tween to a size of 42 by 42, the circle's original dimensions. Press F5, and when we press the up arrow, the circle tweens up to 150 by 150. If I press the down arrow, it tweens back down to its original size. We can even trigger both of them at the same time. If I click the circle and then press the up key, both tweens occur simultaneously. Now, that alone is pretty useful and can be used to create some great stuff. But what really makes the tween behavior shine is when we start to use easing. Currently, every tween we've set up has used the linear easing mode, which means it tweens between the two values at a steady rate from start to finish. Easing lets us vary the rate that the value changes over the duration of the tween, so we could have it start moving the circle slowly and begin to speed up more rapidly over time. Or the opposite, we could have it start moving quickly and then slowly ease into its final position. Let's take a look at an example to see what I mean. I've got these five dice set up here, one dice object with five different frames. The dice object has the tween behavior applied to it. In the event sheet, I have an event set up for each of the dice so that when I press a key on the number pad, 1 through 5, it will affect the corresponding dice, tweening it over to the second to last row. I've got a different easing mode applied to each separate instance of the dice object. Let's preview the layout and see how they each look. The first dice has linear easing, which we used on the circle earlier. If I press the 1 key, it tweens to the right side of the screen, moving along steadily at the same rate. The second dice has the N-sinusoidal easing type, which means it starts out slowly, then increases at a steady rate after. If we look at the easing modes displayed on a graph, this is what linear and N-sinusoidal look like. Notice linear increases steadily, while N-sinusoidal starts out slow, then increases steadily after. If I press 2, the second die tweens to the right side, but it doesn't move at a steady rate like the first did. Let's look at 1 and 2 moving together. 1 starts off faster, but once they get to the right side, 2 begins to catch up. They both reach the same point at the same time, but the easing mode on the second die affects the rate it moves during the tween. Let's look at it one more time. The first die with linear easing looks mechanical. Its movement isn't natural at all. The second die has a more natural movement between the two points, since it's not moving at a constant rate. If we look at the easing types available, there are a bunch of them, but it's not hard to break them all down, since each of the easing types has three variations. They can ease in, ease out, or ease both in and out. Each of the types, sinusoidal, elastic, back, bounce, cubic, quadratic, quartic, quintic, circular, and exponential, each have these three variations, in, out, and in out. We used ease in on the second die, and remember how it behaved. It slowly eased in and then moved steady for the rest of the time. Ease out does the opposite. It moves along steadily from the start, but then slowly eases off at the end of the tween. In out combines both of them. It will ease in at the beginning, move steadily along during the middle, and will ease out at the end. Let's look at them in action. The second die eases in. I have the third die set up to ease out. And the fourth die eases in and out, all of them using the sinusoidal easing mode. Let's look at them together. The third die starts off the quickest. Number 4 starts to catch up, but they all finish at the same time. Watch each of them as they move with the first die with the linear easing mode. The second die eases in. The third die eases out. And the fourth eases in and out. Notice the fourth moves faster than the second, even though they both ease in. That's because the fourth die needs to move faster because it also eases out. The fifth die has a different easing type applied, bounce, and it's using the ease in variation. Bounce will take the object and bounce it on its starting or ending point before sending it over to its final position. This is what the ease in bounce looks like on a graph. It moves forward a small amount, then back to its starting point, then bounces a little further, and even further until it finally reaches its target. Using these easing modes, you can really enhance the feel of your games. When every movement's linear, every fade or every item that drops in follows a perfect, steady movement, it makes the game feel generic and sterile. It's not something that's directly noticeable to most players, but subconsciously they'll know and they'll feel less interested. Players want the game to feel natural and human, not mechanical and robotic. Easing is one of the ways that we can do that. So, now that we know this, let's go back to our first example and update the tweens so they use easing. Also, let's drag out an instance of the triangle object, and we'll set up a tween to rotate it. Switch to the event sheet, and add a new event. Using the keyboard object, we'll use on key pressed, and set it to the space bar. Add an action, using the triangle object, and we'll choose tween one property. Let's use the tag of this tween to trigger another tween. Set the tag to rotate triangle. We can use this to refer to the tween later, triggering events when this tween is playing or completed. Set the property to affect the angle, and set the time to 1 second. For the end value, I want to add 90 degrees to the triangle's current angle. So let's enter spr_triangle.angle plus 90. Last, let's set the ease mode to in bounce. Then let's change the easing mode for the other tweens also. Let's set the move in tween to in cubic, and then the move back to out cubic. For the size tween, let's set the easing mode to out elastic. For both tweens. Alright, let's preview the layout and see how these look. If I click on the circle, it moves across the layout, but it eases into full speed. We can make it go back, and it eases out, and it has a more natural movement than it did with linear easing. What about if we make it larger? Once it reaches its full size, it bounces a bit, a completely different effect than what linear gave us. Last, let's try the space bar to rotate the triangle. It bounces a bit before it rotates 90 degrees. You can see how using the tween behavior and selecting the right easing mode can add a unique feeling to your game's objects. But let's take it even further and chain these tweens together. I want the triangle's rotation to skew the circle on each turn. Remember earlier, we set the tag on the triangle's tween to rotate triangle, so we could refer to it later. Add a new event. Using the triangle object. Under the tween category, select on finished. This will trigger an event when a tween with the specified tag is completed. I'll enter rotate triangle and click done. Hold down control and drag out a copy of the circle's size tween down to our new event. Double click to edit the properties and change the end x to 75. Then, create a sub-event under the onTweenFinished event using the circle and choose Compare With. We're going to check if the width is equal to 75, and if it is, we'll skew the circle the other way. Drag down a copy of the circle tween and change the end x to 150. And the end Y to 75. Alright, let's preview the layout. Now, when we click the space bar, the triangle rotates, and when its tween completes, the circle's tween is activated, and it's skewed. If we rotate it again, it's skewed the other way. You can chain as many tweens together as you'd like, so you can create complex animation chains being triggered by only one event. There are lots of cool things we can do with this new behavior, so make sure you start experimenting with it. Look into using the third type of tween, the value tween, to adjust any other value in the same way that we're doing here. Just assign the value of the tween to another parameter in the event sheet. Also, learn more about each of the easing modes and how they affect the animation that the tween behavior creates. Thanks for watching. See you next time.